Today, we're very excited to show you how to set up our new TS4. Longtime users will be happy to see that the process is much the same as before, and our new users may be surprised to see how simple the TS4 is to use. Hi, my name's Jonathan. I'm a part of the CalDigit support team. Let's jump right in. The TS4 comes with everything you need to get started, except wall power and a compatible computer. The TS4 is compatible with macOS Big Sur or later, as well as iPads, Windows, starting at Windows 10, version 20H2 and newer, and up-to-date Chrome OS devices. Any of these types of devices with a Thunderbolt 3, Thunderbolt 4, USB 4, or other USB-C protocol will be compatible. The TS4 comes with a quick start guide, support information, and some rubber feet for laying the dock on its side. Also included is a Thunderbolt 4 cable, as well as a power adapter and cable. The included Thunderbolt 4 cable is compatible with all specifications of USB-C, including USB 4, Thunderbolt 3, and USB 3 iterations. As for power, right here we have a US plug, but if you order your TS4 in another region, it will come with that region's plug. The power cable itself uses a commonly found C13 plug type, so swapping for another region is quick and easy. We'll put these aside for now and focus on the TS4 itself. The TS4 has two main configurations. It can easily be stood up vertically, or it can rest horizontally with those included rubber feet, depending on your preference. We'll start by plugging in the power cable, making sure there's a firm connection between the power plug-in outlet, power plug-in adapter, and cable to the TS4. Good! Next, we'll connect the Thunderbolt cable. One end plugs into the computer, and the other end plugs into the TS4. On the TS4, plug into the Thunderbolt port labeled Computer. This port can provide up to a whopping 98 watts of charging for a connected device. For computers or tablets that require less than 98 watts, the TS4 will only supply as much power as the devices need. On the other side of the spectrum, some computers can make use of much more power, such as the 16-inch M1 MacBook Pro with the M1 Pro or M1 Max chips, which utilize up to 140 watts. The TS4 is capable of charging such devices, albeit at a slower rate, than the factory charger. On the topic of charging, we frequently get asked if the power from our docks is safe for already powered devices, such as the Mac Mini, iMac, or other desktop computers. The answer is yes. Modern computers are smart enough to only accept power that they need. Desktop devices will simply not accept the power from the TS4, but everything will function normally. Likewise, on a laptop or tablet, you can use both the TS4 and the charger that came with your computer at the same time. In this case, the computer will only accept power from a single source. So, after plugging in power and the Thunderbolt port on the TS4, we can turn on the computer, and the LED indicator light should activate on the TS4, which means we're set up on the hardware side. This light will only turn on when the TS4 has both a connection to power and the computer itself, so it's easy to see if things are working properly. If you're on a macOS device running macOS Big Sur later, an iPad, or using a USB-C connection on Windows or Chrome OS, that's it. Setup complete. Enjoy your new dock. Some Windows computers using Thunderbolt may also work at this point. Check and see for yourself. We'll discuss what to look for in the upcoming Windows segment ahead. As a bonus for macOS users, we also have a docking station utility that can be used to quickly eject all USB storage devices at once, which can be convenient if you intend to frequently connect and disconnect your device. It's a quick install, very easy and straightforward to set up. We'll have a link to that in the description below. As for using Thunderbolt through other operating systems, some extra steps may be required for the dock to work as intended. In the rest of this video, we'll cover steps for both Windows and then for Chrome OS. There's chapters listed down below if you're on Chrome OS and want to skip ahead. Some Windows computers may already work with the TS4 out of the box. If at this point your USB, Ethernet, and remaining ports are in full working order, then you're done, no further setup required. Otherwise, we have one more quick step to get your new dock fully functional. To help improve security on Windows, Thunderbolt devices require authorization. Thankfully, the authorization process is very straightforward when implemented properly by the computer's manufacturer. As soon as a new Thunderbolt device is plugged in, RTS4 for example, a prompt from the program Thunderbolt Software or Thunderbolt Control Center pops up and asks what you'd like to do with the device. We recommend selecting Always Connect, which will prevent you from having to repeat this process every time you plug in your TS4. From there, the TS4 should work as intended. If the pop-up prompt didn't appear when the TS4 was first connected, you can manually approve it. Open the Thunderbolt Software or Control Center by searching for Thunderbolt in the Windows search or select the program from the Start menu or Taskbar. If you can't find the programs, you may need to install them. We offer up-to-date Thunderbolt drivers and software on our website, which we will have in the link below. Also linked is additional information and troubleshooting from our knowledge base. Similar to Windows, Thunderbolt-based Chrome OS devices may require an extra step to get the full functionality out of your TS4. This process is only necessary on Thunderbolt and USB 4 Chromebooks. USB 3 Type-C Chromebooks will already work at this point. Either way, it's a simple process and you may be prompted on it when the TS4 is first plugged in. We'll start by going into Settings. You can do this either by clicking Settings on the prompt, if available, or selecting the time, then navigating to Settings. From here, click on the Security and Privacy section, and on this page, turn off Data Access Protection for Peripherals. The TS4 should now be working as intended. If something does not go as expected here, Google does have a help page for this process, which may be able to help you further. We've linked it below. And there you have it. It's as simple as that to set up your new TS4. As always, if you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to our support team. Contact methods are right here on the screen and also in the description below. For any updates on our products, you can follow us on our social media channels, also listed down below. We hope you found this video useful. Thanks, and have a great day.